السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back my friend to my channel on YouTube, Drilling and Workover. This is Abdelaziz Gabr. I am accredited instructor in IWC Fuel Control and IEDC with Sharp. I am also accredited instructor in IEDC Mud Engineering Basic and Advanced Mud School. Yesterday we have talked about the introduction to the basic mud school, and we discussed the syllabus and the content of the course that we take inshallah in the course. So today is the first day in the course, and it is very important lesson. It's called the geology. It's called the geology of the course, Introduction to Geology. Why we study geology in the basic mud school? Actually, you are drilling, so there are different formations that you will face. So you have to know some basic information about geology in order to understand the reactions of the formation and its problems that may face you while drilling. So the origin of petroleum. What is the origin of petroleum? Actually, there are two theories about the petroleum, about the origin of petroleum. The first one that said that the petroleum is formed during the formation of the Earth, and this is by the way, no more than 1%. Who can confirm about this theory. But the most and the most common and the widest spread theory is that the petroleum originally began from an organic material, which may be from plants and animals that were very abundant or very available, for example, okay? Over the years, this material has slowly decayed, and became our present day fossil fuels, oil, or bitumen, gas, and coal. Let's make it simple. If you are, for example, if you are, or if your city, for example, has been buried under a mountain or something like this, suddenly an earthquake happened and the large rocks over the city has buried all the people, and those people were not permitted to see the air, or not to see the air, the bacteria, the air bacteria, not to go and make their bodies to be decayed. So that those its material or their material, their meat, their the land will under the pressure and temperature by the millions of years and millions of years of precipitation of sand and of clay and blah blah blah. After millions of years and pressure and temperature, it will form, it will change from a state to another state where we find the petroleum today, inshallah. These are the geological ages or the geological era, and as you see here, the age is with millions of billions of years. With millions of years, as you see here, so that when we are saying 1 million, it is nothing in the age of the Earth. This means that it was just 1 million. So as you see here, this is from the most updated, or from the youngest age to the here is called sometimes the basement. It is called the basement, or it is called the most the oldest age, on the geological ages. So this is very important. But okay, there is no need to know them, but it's just for common knowledge about the geology. The rock categories that we are dealing with. First type is called igneous rock. And what is the igneous rock? It is the rocks that formed by cooling or congealing rapidly or slowly from the molten state. For example, there was a volcano, and this volcano threw some lava from inside, to the outside, and those lava have been cooled maybe slowly, maybe rapidly, and after cooling, its rock is called igneous rock, like the granite, like the marble or marl, something like this. All these that we are using in making the same, okay, we are using in our home, okay, those are like, for example, basalt or something like this. Number two, there are some metamorphic rocks, which are the rocks formed by alteration due to application of heat and pressure, or heat or pressure of the pre-existing rocks. So this means that the rocks has been in another, in one state, and after formation, after it has been formed, it can be changed to another one by pressure and temperature. So this is very important, the metamorphic rock. The last one and the most important one is called the sedimentary rock. And sedimentary rocks are materials that have been deposited over geological time or in basin of deposition. This is very important, and this is what we will talk about. The sedimentary rocks. There are two types. Someone is called the clastic sedimentary rocks, like the sandstone, where it consists primarily by particles that have been eroded from one location on the Earth's surface and transported by air, by wind, through, for example, the glacier, it's called the ice, okay, the ice balls, and also by the river, the sea. Anyway, it is transported by it to another location and deposited in the new location as sediments. Okay, this is called the clastic. Like the most common one is the sandstone, is also a sedimentary rock. Also there is shale or clay. All these are the clastic rocks. Number two, there is non-clastic or chemical sedimentary rocks. What are the non-clastic? Like the carbonates, like limestone rocks formed by precipitation of calcium carbonates. Okay. And also there is evaporites, which are consisting of minerals that has been precipitated, like the salt and other types of salt, like evaporite salt. So the carbonates like limestone, like dolomite, like the clastic rock has something is called primary porosity, but carbonates has many fractures and many vagues. It's called secondary porosity, okay? And why we use it, for example, the limestone, calcium carbonate, and the dolomite, calcium magnesium carbonate, are also common sedimentary reservoir rock, and it has fractures and vagular pore spaces may be interconnected by fractures, facilitating the porosity and the permeability necessary for oil to migrate. So this is very important to deal with, because why we said that the limestone has fractures inside it, because we will talk now about very important parameters are called the rock properties, porosity and permeability. Okay, the porosity of the rock. What is the meaning of the porosity of the rock? This the mean that the rock has the volume of the voids by the total volume of the rocks. This is called the porosity. Okay. And also the permeability. The permeability is when these voids are interconnected like this. When there is void between the grains, this is called porous rock. But when these are interconnected like this, this is called permeable rocks. So any rock can be classified as porous, permeable, non-porous, non-permeable, porous, non-permeable, whatever. So the most important here, you know, the, on our rocks, that the sandstone is porous and permeable, but not high permeable. The limestone is porous and the high permeable limestone. So the most problems can happen in dolomite and limestone. Why? Because it is the high permeable. So the stuck problems, differential stuck, can occur in the limestone. Also, the well control issues can happen in limestone. There is also some rocks which are porous but non-permeable, like the shale, for example. It's very porous but non-permeable. So there is very important question you will be asked, is there any differential stuck in the shale? For example, for sure, there is no differential stuck in the shale. But there is another type of stuck that we will talk about later, inshallah. So the rocks can be classified as I told you, porous and permeable, because this is very important classification. Migration of oil over the petroleum. Oil is not found in the formation like a tank, but it is found in the voids, between the voids of the grains of the between the voids of the grains of the rock, for example. So this is very important. It is not in tank in the earth, but it is found in the voids of the rock. So oil is seldom found in commercial amounts in the source rock, okay, where it is was formed. Normally it migrates to nearby reservoir rock. So here we will talk about some new idioms. What's the meaning of source rock? What's the meaning of reservoir rock? What's the meaning of cab rock? Actually, for any reservoir, it must have source rock, which is porous, non-permeable. Why porous, non-permeable? Because it has this rock properties have the capability for the oil to be formed inside it. And after some time of heating and pressure and temperature and the pressure, there is called the cooking, which happened to the mature material, and it makes it from mature material to oil and gas, but it is still trapped in its place. But when the migration happens, actually migration happens, happens from the source rock to the reservoir rock by something is called capillary pressure or capillary force. And no need to get in details about these issues, but you have to know that the reservoir rock, okay, has porous and permeable. So that the sandstone can be reservoir, yes, sandstone can be reservoir. The limestone can be reservoir. Even another types of rocks which are porous and permeable. And there is something is called cab rock. What is the cab rock? The cab rock means that it is rock which is impermeable. Maybe porous, may not be porous. Okay, but it is impermeable rock which makes a trap for the reservoir rock, so that traps the oil inside the reservoir. Okay, so petroleum is found in the void spaces. This is called porosity. So oil accumulation can be in the source rock, which is porous and impermeable. Impermeable, this is very important. And reservoir rock, which is porous and permeable. And cab rock, which is porous or non-porous, there is no problem. And it is impermeable rock. Migration of petroleum fluid, as I told you, some water remains here here during the cooking. During the cooking of the mature material, it turns to water, oil, and gas, so that the oil, the water, is connected directly to the rocks, because the rocks are water wet. This means that the outer layer of the rocks the outer layer of the rocks is has something, some water is called connate water, or coating water is called connate water, which cannot be produced. Actually, this connate water, if the permeability of the rock is high and this connate water has blocked the way on the oil, you will need to make something is called enhanced oil recovery. But this is large problems that we can talk many times. That's another course. And sorry to open this issue now. Oil and gas migrates between the pore spaces as long as there is enough pressure or gravity forces to move it, and it moves until it finds blockage called geological thread. As I told you here, for example, there is source rock, and by the capillary pressure, it migrates and continue migration and of the oil until it finds something that can make a trap, for the oil, like here, as you see. So, and this shape here, as you see, it's called anticline trap, or someone is called structure trap, and here, anticline type. So what are the traps? Under proper condition of pressure, buoyancy, and natural gravity, oil and gas will migrate until it is stopped by impermeable barrier. Impermeable barrier. So this is very important. The cap rock or the barrier must be impermeable. This is called trap. Oil and water and gas accumulate in this trap, and over time, it will separate with water settling to the lowest point, oil in the middle and the gas to the top. And this is very important because of the gravity. Water is down, and oil in the middle and the gas in the above. And you know, so that we can make, if we need to enhance the production, we can make, for example, water flooding to pump water to in the bottom, so that the oil can be produced, and also we can make gas injection from the upper, and it also helps to increase the rate of production of oil. Okay, so this is very important to know about this. What are the traps categories? There are two categories. One is called the structure trap, which are formed when the rocks are deformed or faulted. So this is the meaning that the rocks were formed, and after the rocks has been formed, there is some tectonic forces happened to the earth, and at this time there is new structure. It's called structure trap. Example of structure trap are anticline trap, fault trap, salt dome trap, etc. And the other type is called stratigraphic traps. What is the stratigraphic traps? This means that there is a rock, okay, and after some time it has some erosion happened to its surface, and after this another rock has been deposited with no permeability, so that the oil, when the oil is going up or something, or migration, it can be stopped by this barrier. So the stratigraphic traps are formed by geological process other than the deformation. So this means that it can, like the sand trap, or like the sand, it's called sand lens, the sand filled river, and anything. Structure trap, like the anticline, as you see here, anticline, where oil and gas migrate to the top of the anticline structure and hit the impermeable ceiling rock structure, as you see, and as I told you here, it is migrating here and continue migration until impermeable rock, and for this it can be trap. Structure trap, like the fault one. Why is the fault? As you see here, this layer was the extension of this layer, but there is a fault happened due to some tectonic forces happened on the earth, so that there is a permeable layer like this against impermeable one, against impermeable layer, and so that the oil can migrate until it is trapped here. So this is called fault trap, where it is formed by movement of rock along the fault line, And some reservoir, or in some cases, the reservoir rock has moved opposite a layer of impermeable rock, which prevents the oil from escaping. The structure trap also here is called the salt dome. And to be honest, the salt dome is the most common in the Gulf of Suez. As you see here, the salt has less density than the surrounding layers, so that it makes intrusions like the dome. You see, like the dome, so that when this is permeable, so the oil can migrate from here, until it is trapped by impermeable surface here, which is the salt dome and another rock. So the salt dome traps also can be also as a structure. Stratigraphic traps, as I told you, there is a change formed by geological process other than deformation. And as I told you, it is like the sandbars or the sand lenses. As you see here, this is shale and this is sand, and also this is shale, this is sand, so that the oil can be in the porous and permeable one, and it is surrounded with non-permeable rock, like sand filter. The stratigraphic traps also can be something that's called unconformity. What is the unconformity? Unconformity means there is two different layers or two different types of rocks, like here, as you see. The unconformity occur when strata or formation have been eroded or uplifted and tilted, okay, no problem, and eroded at the surface, and new impermeable sediments has been deposited on the top. So this is called unconformity, and there are four types of unconformity. But there is no need now to mention everything in this course, but you have to know there is something that's called unconformity. How we know that this place has some accumulation of oil? For example, why in your city there is no oil, but in other cities has oil? Actually, we make something that's called the exploration or survey, and after the survey or the exploration, we can check for the oil. How we make the survey? First, we can use the satellites, and after this, we make something is called seismic, and the seismic can give us plus or minus 80% or 90% that there is here accumulation of oil, and the accumulation of oil can be economic amounts or cannot be in economic amounts, so that if we make calculations about that and found it is economic, we can go ahead and start the operation for drilling. If it is not economic at the present time, it may be economic later when the oil prices are going up or new technologies that can make the extraction of the oil to be not expensive or to be cheap, so we can use it later. So the geophysics or exploration, as you see, it gives us the something like this, but we make very editing to it, and I will show you the last picture of this data. How we make it? By the seismic, as I told you, this is the seismology. What is the meaning of seismic and seismology that we use? The most common is method, as I told you, is the seismic. We send shock waves downwards into the rock strata, and the reflection of these waves back to sensitive surfaces, like it's called geophones. And after we get the signals on the geophone, we can make editing to these signals, and after making editing to it to remove the noise, to remove the other things in it, so that we can get the final image of it. And it will show you very nice picture now. According to a different in density and the hardness of the rocks, the reflection of the waves are different or have different rates of speed, so that we can expect that this rock, if it is dry, it will it will the it the it, if the rock is dry, the reflection or the wave the velocity of the wave inside it will not be as if it is wet, and if it is wet with water, not like oil, not like gas. So this is very important to know about these issues. Seismologists interpret the variance in reflection and can model the strata. As you see here, we make here dynamite or shots or bomb or whatever, and to send waves. So these are waves which reflect the rock layer, and we can receive all the reflection waves on something is called geophones on the surface, and we can make editing to the data until it is like this. There is here a fault, there is here another fault, and here another fault. So we can expect that this is a trap, and this is a trap. And after this, we make something is called contour mapping, and the contour mapping can you get the accumulation of oil, and you can check if the after contouring the map, the amounts the accumulated amount of oil is economic and can be extracted with good profit. We can go ahead and start drilling. If it is not like this, we can wait until it is economic, maybe in the future. So this is very important. Thank you very much. Today we have talked about the geology, and this is very important to know for our first lesson in the basic mud school. And inshallah tomorrow with another lesson in basic mud school. So that keep tuned for tomorrow. If this video appeals to you, share, like, subscribe. Thank you very much. See you later inshallah tomorrow. Thank you very much.